فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، فأوصيكم عباد الله ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته. My beloved brothers and sisters, I advise myself and each and every one of you to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to fear Him privately and publicly. قال سبحانه الله سبحانه وتعالى, He said in the Quran, اعدلوا, be just, هو أقرب للتقوى. Justness is closest to piety. واتقوا الله, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is one who is of high level of knowledge in that which you do. أَيُّهَا الْمُسْلِمُونَ, my beloved brothers and sisters, خَلَقَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, Allah created the heavens, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the earth. عَلَىٰ أُسُسٍ عَظِيمًا, He created it on a very strong foundation. وَثَوَابِتَ قَوِيمًا, وَمِنْ أَعْظَمِهَا, and from the greatest foundations. وَأَرْسَخِهَا, the most rooted and the most strongest foundation in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it all is الْعَدْلُ, to be just, to be fair. فَفِيهِ, through justness, قامت الدنيا, this whole world runs because of Allah's justness subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِهِ اسْتَقَامَتِ الْحَيَاةِ, and our life that we're going through, every piece of it and every moment of it, it is steadfast and it's working because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's adl. قَالَ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ, Allah says in the Quran, وَالسَّمَاءَ, the heavens, وَرَفَعَهَا, Allah lifted it subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has placed the scales. Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi, the Mufassir, he said, أي وضع في الأرض العدل وأمر به, Allah, He placed on this earth justness and He commanded it subhanahu wa ta'ala. وبالعدل نزل القرآن, and because of Allah's justness, He was kind and merciful to us that He sent a book for us subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال سبحانه, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, الله الذي أنزل الكتاب بالحق والميزان, Allah is the one who sent down the kitab, the Quran, with haq, والميزان, and the scale. قال بعض المفسرين, some of the scholars of tafsir, they said, الميزان هو العدل, the scale means justness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one who took over the affairs of His creations. Everything that takes place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it. He has written a destination for it subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is one who stands for justice. قال تعالى, Allah says in the Quran, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the first to testify that there is none worthy of worship except him. وَالْمَلَائِكَ, and the angels, they testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ, and the people of knowledge, they also testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ, all of them, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, they stand for justice. لا إله إلا هو, there is none worthy of worship except him. هو العزيز الحكيم, Allah is one who whatever he wants it will take place. حكيم, one who is wise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he also says, لقد أرسلنا رسلنا, we have sent our messengers بالبينات, with clear evidences. وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب, and we sent with them the books. وَالْمِيزَانَ, and the scale. لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ, so they can stand with justice between the creation. So if a person is looking for justice today and he wants to find fairness, then he will find it in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَمَا مِن نَبِيٍ, there is no prophet, أَرْسَلَهُ اللَّهُ, in which Allah sent subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِلَّا أَمَرَهُ بِالْعَدْلِ, except Allah commanded him to be just. قال جل شأنه, Allah said لداود, to نبي الله داود عليه السلام, he said, يا داود, أو داود, إنا جعلناك خليفة في الأرض, we have made you a governor on this earth. فاحكم بين الناس بالقسط, judge the people based on justice. وأمر نبينا بالعدل, and Allah تبارك وتعالى, he commanded our prophet محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم to be just. Allah said to him, وإن حكمت, Muhammad, if you judge between the people, فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ, judge between the people based on justice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُخْسِطِينَ, Allah loves those who are just, those who are fair, Allah loves them. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُخْسِطِينَ, it means أي العادلين, those who are just. وقال أيضا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he also says, وَقُلْ آمَنْتُ, say, I believe بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ, that which Allah has sent down. مِنْ كِتَابٍ, from the books. وَأُمِرْتُ, and I was commanded. لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ, to be just to each and every one of you. The Prophet is saying this, عليه الصلاة والسلام. قال ابن جرير الطبري, ابن جرير says, أُمِرَ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ, أُمِرَ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger of Allah was commanded, أَنْ يَعْدِلَ, to be just. فَعَدَلَ حَتَّى كَانَ الْعَدْلُ مِنْهَاجَهُ, the messenger was just until justness was his methodology, the way he lived his life صلى الله عليه وسلم. And today if you look at the situation of the people and you look at their affairs, you might differ with a person based on a worldly matter and based on his injustness, his ظلم and his عدوان, he will automatically drag the matter to the religion and he will say, the khilaf and the dispute between me and so-and-so is for Allah's sake. It is the religion why we differ. But the reality is it's a worldly matter. It has nothing to do with the religion. You also tend to find that people will base injustice to the person who's closest to them. If a person is from their tribe, if a person is from their group, they will give something to them, which that same thing, for another person it was wrong. Or a close friend of yours will do something, you have 70 excuses for them, but when somebody else does it, there is no excuse. أيها المؤمنون, O believers, إن الله تعالى أمركم بالعدل, the way Allah commanded the previous prophets and the way he commanded the messengers, he commanded each and every one of you to be just and to be fair. قال تعالى, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إن الله يأمركم, Allah commands each and every one of you, بالعدل, to be just, to be fair. وقال جل وعلا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, oh those of you who believe, if you have true iman in your heart and you believe in Allah and the day of judgment, Allah says to you, كونوا بي قوامين بالقسط, somebody who stands for justness and be fair, شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم, even if it has to be justice on yourself. Even if you do something wrong, you say, wallahi, I don't agree with this person generally, but this issue, wallahi, he's right in it. أو الوالدين or your parents والأقربين and the closest to you. فأمر سبحانه, Allah is commanding each and every one of us to be just. My beloved brothers and sisters, Islam is a religion from the day it started. إلى أن يرث الله الأرض ومن عليها, until Allah تبارك وتعالى takes off the, over this earth and everything in it. It's a religion that stands for justness. It's a religion that stands for عدل القسط. It stands for it in all of the, its affairs. And the people who are just, this is the reward they get. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, a hadith Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, that the Prophet said, إِنَّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, the people who are just, they have with Allah, and they are عَلَى مَنَابِرَ مِنْ نُورِ, they are on pulpits of light. عَنْ يَمِينِ الرَّحْمَانِ, on the right side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكِلْتَ يَدَيْهِ يَمِينِ, and both of the hands of Allah are right. الَّذِينَ يَعْدِلُونَ فِي حُكْمِهِمْ, and they are the ones who are just in the things that they judge. وَأَهْلِيهِمْ, and they are fair and they are just in their families. وَمَا وَلَوْ, and those things in which they have taken over and they control, they are just. فَبُشْرَى, glad tidings. To who? Every single person who comes with this noble characteristics, justness. Ikhwani, the people who are just, their symbol of life and the way they live their life is what? الحق أحق أن يتبع. The truth is the truth and it deserves to be followed. And that is what I need to know. Is this the haq? I will take it. It doesn't matter who it comes from. It doesn't matter who utters it. The truth is a lost property of mine. I was the one who owned it in the first place and I found my lost property. The believer, that's how he looked at it. ولذلك عمار رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, ثلاث, three, من جمعهن, anyone who these three are in him, فقد جمع الإيمان, then إيمان is compiled in him. He truly has إيمان. And from those three was what? الإنصاف من نفسك, to be just even in yourself. To be just even in yourself. ولذلك we find in the book Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah, in his kitab Jami'u Bayan al-Ilm wa Fadli, he talks about Imam Malik rahimahullah, Imam Dar al-Hijra. Imam Malik, it was said to him that your kitab al-Muwatta, the book he authored, he was told that this book of his will govern the Muslims and it will be placed over everybody. There is not a land except this book will be sent to it. And this would be the thing that is controlled by everybody. The matter, the ruler, he presented the matter to Imam Malik and he said, from this minute onwards, your book, Al-Muwatta, everybody has to follow it. Imam Malik, when he told him, he said, La taf'al, don't do this. Allahu Akbar. Don't force my... Because Kitab Al-Muwatta, even though it has in it the statements of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but it also has the fiqh and the understanding of Imam Malik rahimahullah. He said, no, the opinions of the other companions and other views in Masail al-Fiqh have preceded to the people already. They've heard of it. And they've become pleased with those opinions. Don't force my book on them. I ask each and every one of you who can read the Arabic language, read what Ibn Abdul Barr says after he brings the story of Imam Malik rahimahullah. He mentions that this insaf, this fairness within a person, it's little to find it in people. People today want you to follow their opinion. If you don't follow it, every su and every qubh is directed at you. My brothers and sisters, justness and adl has to be even placed amongst your own children. Your own children that you have, you have to be just between them. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اعدلوا بفاء بين أولادكم في النحل. Be fair and be just in the way you deal with your children, in what you give, the gifts and what you give them. كما تحبون, the way you love. أن يعدلوا بينكم, the way you love for them to be good to you. The way you want them to take care of you and be just to you. Be like that towards them. في البر, to be just. وَاللُّطْفِ, and for them to be good and kind to you when you grow old. Remember to be just among your children. My brothers and sisters, when you're buying and you're selling and you're in the market, be just in the things that you take. If the person in the market has given you extra, be just and be fair and bring it back and say, this is not my rights. The Messenger sallallahu tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَأَوْفُوا بِجَسْتْ الْكَيْلَ in your scaling. إِذَا كِلْتُمْ وَزِنُوا بِالْقِسْطَاسِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. When you're scaling, be fair and be just in the way you scale. Even in the tijarat and the mu'amalat al-maliyah that the people deal with one another, be just. Don't forget justice. I'm going to finally conclude with that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam he said. A companion came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Imam Ahmad narrated this in his Musnad, that a man قَدْ سَأَلَ أَحَدُ الصَّحَابَةِ, one of the companions, he asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to the Prophet, نَبِّئْنِي بِعَمَلٍ, tell me a action, يُقَرِّبُنِي مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, that will get me closer to Jannah, وَيُبَاعِدُنِي مِنَ النَّارِ, and it will distance me from the hellfire. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Prophet said to him, تَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ, you worship Allah, لَا تُشْرِكْ بِهِ شَيْئًا, do not associate partners with me, and do not associate partners with him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَتَأْتِي إِلَى النَّاسِ مَا تُحِبُّ أَن يُؤْتُوهُ إِلَيْكَ, come and deal with the people in the way you love to be dealt with. Deal with the people and treat the people the way you love to be dealt with, the way you love to be cared for. Just do that to the people. وَمَا كَرِهْتَ لِنَفْسِكَ, anything you dislike for yourself, فَدَعِ النَّاسَ مِنْهُ, leave the people from this. Don't deal with the people in that way. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, justness and adl and fairness also has to occur in the affairs of one's dealing with his family, your wife and your children. I've already mentioned the matter pertaining to the children, but to be fair and just even in your wives, the way you deal with them. ولذلك the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, I mean Allah تبارك وتعالى, he said, وَلَهُنَّ, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he said, it's for the women, مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, it is for the women, everything that is for the man. Whatever rights and haq that you have on her, she has the likes of it on you. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he said, وَلَهُنَّ عَلَى الرِّجَالِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ بِمِثْلُ مَا لِلرِّجَالِ عَلَيْهِنَّ فَلْيُؤَدِّ كُلُّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا إِلَى الْآخَرِ مَا يُحِبُّ إِلَيْهِ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he said, that the wives, they have rights over the men the same in which the man has over the wife. You demanding for your rights and asking for it as much as it, she has the rights to demand for her rights. Islam has not left anything except it commands for a person to be just. My beloved brothers and sisters, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, he says, Allah gives victory to a disbeliever who governs a people, if he is just, Allah gives him victory. If a leader is not Muslim, he's a disbeliever, but he is just, Allah gives him victory. And if a believer is unjust, Allah doesn't give him victory. Ikhwani, adl is important in all of our tasarrufat and everything we do. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وأقم الصلاة.